Welcome to the Blazor OTP Input tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor OTP Input component. The Blazor OTP Input is a versatile form component designed for entering one-time passwords during multi-factor authentication. It accepts a single character per input field, ensuring a focused, straightforward user experience. You can also find customization options with built-in features, including input types, styling modes, placeholders, separator, appearance, and more. Before proceeding, ensure that you have the .NET 8 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web application and provide the project name. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project and have selected the auto-render mode for both server and WebAssembly apps under the Interactive Render Mode section. Apart from this, there are four other modes. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now, the application is ready to use. Next, I will show you how to add the Blazor OTP input component. First, I need to install the NuGet package in my application. So I open the NuGet package manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor inputs package, and install the latest version. Also, I install the themes NuGet package to host CSS and script files. After installation, I navigate to the imports razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor inputs namespace to use the component within the pages folder. Next, I open the client-side program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I register the Syncfusion service to use the Blazor OTP input component. I also add the services to the server-side program CS file. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component to host the script and refer to the CSS for the component. Here, everything is configured, so open the Home Razor component, remove the default code, and add a division tag with ID attribute. Within this division tag, define the Syncfusion Blazor OTP input component. Afterward, apply the styles to the division element for UI alignment. Let's run the example application. Look here, the Blazor OTP input component rendered on the home page. Next, I will show you how to customize the length of the Blazor OTP input component. To do this, set the length property. The default value is 4. Now, I set it to 5. Notice that the length of the Blazor OTP input is 5. Next, I will show you how to add input types in the component. To do this, set the value property to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Additionally, set the type property. There are three types available: number, text, and password. By default, the type property is set to number. So, in this case, there is no need to set the type property explicitly. The Blazor OTP input component is rendered with the provided number value. If you want to display both letters and numbers, set the input type to text. Then I change the value property to include some letters and numbers. Now you can see the OTP input component rendered with the provided both the text and number value. Finally, if you want to hide the provided value and display it as dots, like a password, change the type property to password. Looking here, the provided value is displayed as dots. Next, I will show you how to change the styling modes. By default, the styling mode is outlined. To change it, first I changed a type from password to text for clear understanding purpose. Then add the styling mode property. There are three modes: outlined, filled, and underlined. Let me proceed to demonstrate each option by changing the mode type. Since the default mode is outlined, now I set it to filled. Now, observe that the Blazor OTP input component is rendered in filled mode. Next, I'll change it to underline mode. Look now, the OTP input rendered in underlined mode. Next, I will show you how to add a placeholder. For clear understanding purposes, I remove the styling mode property. Also remove the value property, because when I add a placeholder while there is a value, the placeholder might not be visible. Then I add the placeholder property. If I set it to a single character like hash, all input fields will display this character. Look now, you can see the hash is displayed in all the input fields. If you want different characters in each input field, set the placeholder property to multiple characters. For example, I set it to VWXYZ. When multiple characters are provided, each input field displays characters from the placeholder string in sequence based on the Blazor OTP input length. Looking here, each input field displays the provided placeholder characters in sequence. Next, I will show you how to add a separator. First, I define the separator property. The separator in component specifies the character or symbol used to separate each input field to enhance their visual separation. In this case, I use a slash. Look now, the slash is displayed between each input. Next, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the component by changing its colors, fonts, sizes, or other visual aspects. To do this, I set the CSS class property, which supports predefined styles. I set the CSS class to EageSuccess, which represents a positive action. Look now, the component color has changed to green. Next, I change the CSS class from EageSuccess to EageWarning. This class is used to represent an action with caution. Looking here, the Blazor OTP color has changed to orange. Next, I change the CSS class from eWarning to eError, which represents a negative action. Look, the color has changed to red. Finally, to disable the component, simply set the disabled property to true. You'll observe that the Blazor OTP input component is disabled. Now, let me summarize. I demonstrated how to begin customizing the Syncfusion Blazor OTP input component. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from that GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor components. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.